So hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. On today's video, we're actually in Grangeover Sands, South Lakes, and we're going to head from here and up the back roads to a nice little country pub called the Mason's Arms. Now the Mason's Arms, I haven't been to for a long, long time. It used to have a microbrewery behind it, I presume it still does, but it used to sell bottled beer from all over the world, so you could pretty much get any bottle of beer from any country that you liked. So yeah, it's a really, really nice little pub. Tables outside as well as inside, a little limited for space, so I'm not sure how busy it's going to be today. I would expect it's quite busy. As you can see, weather's glorious today. It's about 15 degrees, so still a little bit cool, but I'll take that any day, as well as the nice blue sky on this Easter bank holiday. So happy Easter everyone. Today being Friday, I think today is the best weather day that we're going to get all weekend. So we're out today on the Bonneville. Yeah, so we're going to head along the top road just here to Lindale, drop down, and then we'll do a left by the roundabout in Lindale at the bottom. And then that'll take us along some of the back roads to the Mason's Arms. Now, I've stopped using the Insta360 camera to look back at me. Just the workflow and things about editing. So I've gone ahead and purchased another DJI Action 3 camera, which is on super view, so super wide angle, just on my bars just here, you can see in front of me. And I think that will work quite better really for workflow when I'm editing these videos. Anything to cut down editing time when we're doing them. And this way it'll be obviously the same settings on both cameras looking forward and looking back at me, or wherever else I decide to mount it. But yeah, that's where it's gonna sit for now anyway. Now we're also heading out on Sunday with a couple of pals of mine. They both have multiple different bikes. If you've watched some previous videos, Mark has a old 350 LC Yamaha. Not sure if he'll be on that, or he's meant to be getting a new bike, so let's see what he has on Sunday. Just gonna do a left just here. Little cut through. Past all the lovely little cottages that are down here. And then that road on the right-hand side just there takes you to the little roundabout, Lindale roundabout. You can come up that way if you're coming from the A590. And then yeah, we're just going to go under the A590 just here and head out on these lovely little lanes. So the Bonneville's perfectly suited for these type of roads. I've just put another couple of clicks in the preload on the rear shocks on this bike, as I found them a little bit soft when I went out with my daughter the other night to the pub. Actually realised that the shocks are on the softest settings, which even with my 90 kilos is too soft. So now I've altered them up a couple of clicks. The bike feels a lot better. I have thought about changing the rear shocks on this to the Fox shocks that Triumph do, but I'm not sure if they'll fit with my luggage brackets, to be honest. So I need to check with SW Motouk just to see if they will fit, because I quite fancy the Fox shocks on the back, even though they're about 700 quid for two shocks. Not that cheap. They've got a separate reservoir on them. They'll just make the bike a lot better, as well as I think it's the Tech Bike Parts fork internals, the progressive springs that you can get for the front forks with them not being adjustable, will certainly make the suspension a lot better on this bike. So we'll see if we can get those done prior to going to the Isle of Man TT at the end of May. Now I think the route today, we're gonna, like I say, head up just up the road here to the Masons, get a spot of lunch there, and then from there we're gonna head over the tops, drop down onto the Windermere Road, head up towards Bonus, and then probably go across the ferry that crosses the Lake Windermere, just prior to Bonus, over to the other side towards Sorey, and then make our way round and back down past, I think, Esthwaite Water, where we might call in just for a coffee, an afternoon coffee at the little cafe there. I'll show you that later on the video. So I'm just trying to get my bearings here because I think it's up this way. I could be wrong. This is the road that takes you over towards High Newton. Looking at the long range forecast, I see that the weather's not really warming up until the middle of May. So I do hope it's warm enough for when we go to the Isle of Man TT at the end of May. As I don't fancy camping in freezing cold weather at night. Cows in the field here, and a few calves as well. Awesome. Very nice to see. So just in the right hand side of me here is the Lythe Valley. And the Lythe Valley is the secret route up into the Lake District. Takes you up to Bonus. A very awesome road. As is the route I'm taking here today, up to the Mason's Arms, and then up from there over the top. And we'll actually drop down looking over Lakeside on Lake Windermere, which is pretty spectacular up there. Especially on a day like today. Now, as you can see with the helmet, I've actually got the additional visor from Array for this helmet. One thing I did find when I had the light smoked tinted visor was that I was still getting a lot of sun in my eyes when heading west towards the end of the day, as the sun was very low in the sky. So I've opted for this visor, which literally you can flip up separate, as you can see just there, and it acts as like a like a sunscreen as it's in this position, or you can pop it down over the clear visor that it comes attached to, which I quite like actually, because everything sort of here and above is tinted, and then you've just got this little inch section at the bottom, so which that looks down on the clocks and the instruments of the bike, all clear. So that's quite a nice feature. I didn't know how that would work, but I quite like it actually. It's got a good tint on it, so just keeps the sun out of my eyes, which is great. Not cheap though, as all these things aren't. And at the road end just here, just do a left, and then that white building just up there in front of us is the Mason's Arms. Well, let's go and see what's on the menu, shall we? Now, Mason's Arms at Strawberry Bank. Sadly, they'd stopped serving food at 2 o'clock, so I've just missed it, really. So, had to settle for a shandy. And also a bag of crisps. So that was my lunch today. So definitely we'll have to stop at another cafe somewhere to get a bite to eat. And I think the little boathouse cafe next to Esthwaite Water will do the job. Like I say, long time since I've been to the Mason's Arms at Strawberry Bank, just there. Lovely seating outside, great views. The food's normally great, or used to be great, so I don't expect it to be bad at all. But one thing I did notice, there was a sign saying no food served outside, so even if you wanted to sit outside and grab a bar snack, they weren't serving, it was only inside, which is a little bit sad to see. Hopefully, as the weather warms up a little bit, that will change. But anyway, onwards. So the road we're going over now, just follow that road straight past the Mason's Arms, and this takes you over the fell. But yeah, stunning day. Absolutely beautiful scenery. All the pine forests just on the top of the mountain just here. And then we're just dropping off the other side now. And just on the right just here, not sure if you can see Lake Windermere just down in the bottom. I can see it just now. Literally, this is the start of Lake Windermere. And you've got Lakeside over the other side of the lake there where the ferry boats run from. And they'll go all the way up the lake to Bowness and Ambleside. Stunning part of the world. I'll just pull over here and let you see it. You've got Lakeside just down here. That's where the boats go from. And then the bottom of the lake rolls into Newbury Bridge there, where the Swan and the Newbury Bridge Hotel are. Also good to get some food there. And then what we're going to do, we're going to head down the road here, drop down to the bottom, and then go up to the ferry, about three quarters of the way up the lake, go over to the other side, and then just over the back of that mountain on the other side is Esthwaite Water. You've got Hawkshead, then further than that, one more mountain, you've got Coniston. All great scenery, great roads to travel around on. So, yeah, let's head down. The ferry across is a couple of pounds for a bike. But, yeah, really nice way to get across the lake and see the other side. It drops you off at the other side in Sorey. And also you can visit Beatrix Potter's home over the other side there. But yeah, lovely day and lovely ride out on the Bonneville. Okay, as you get up towards Bowness, just turn left here on the B5285, signposted the ferry. And then about half a mile down this road, just past the car parks, we'll get to the ferry, which runs back and forward over the lake all day. Not sure how many cars are queuing for this one, but we'll find out in a minute when we get round the corner. Oh, there's only a couple. A couple and a bike, I think. There we go. And the ferry's just come in as well, so we should pretty much be going straight on. So yeah, as you can see, just around me you've got all the boats moored up here at the little marina. Motorcycles £2, cars £5. Literally takes 2 minutes to get across the other side. And I find this easier actually than going all the way around the top of the lake by Ambleside, especially in summer when it gets incredibly busy with tourists. Quite a few foot passengers and bicycles coming off. Contactless payment only, no cash, so if you haven't got a card, you can't cross. Okay, so nobody took any money off us. So it looks like bikes were free today. Now, I have paid before on that ferry, but they've also not charged me once before as well, so very nice of them. Very loud 125 cruiser in front that was parked in front of me with no baffles in. A bit too noisy for me, so I'll just let him go out of the way, otherwise I'll just get drowned out by his exhaust note. But yeah, what a stunning day. Beautiful. And what we're going to do is just follow the road around just here until we get to the crossroads ahead, and then we're going to head right towards Sorey as we get to the fork in the roads just at the top here. And then a few miles down this road, we'll get to Hawkshead, where we'll just follow it round to the left, and then head down towards my favourite fishing lake, which is Esthwaite Water. Now, typical schoolboy error when I came out, having bought the new camera. Now, I did put the new camera on my helmet and put the old one on the handlebars. When I put the battery into the new camera, I didn't charge it up, so there was only about 50% battery left. So I've swapped the cameras around now, so I have the original one I was using. And I put the low battery one on the handlebars, which I think has died by now. Okay, so we're just coming up to Hawkshead Village. And I'm just going to turn right into Hawkshead Village, actually, just to show you the square, because it's rather lovely. You've got a fish and chip shop just in the square as well, which is great. Bed and breakfast just there. Ice cream shop. And then the chippy just on your left, just here. Got a few outdoorsy type shops. Couple of cafes and a couple of nice pubs just in the centre here. Little gallery there, Honey Pot Specialist Foods, King's Arms, super place, look at that. Hawkshead Relish Company, get your relishes, and then you've got the Queen's Head, which is another good pub. Poppy Red Bistro just in front. I have to come up here for some fish and chips actually in summer when it gets a bit warmer. Hawkshead Chocolate Fudge Company just there. Lovely place. And then this road just here will take you down alongside Esthwaite Water on the west side, which is where the Boathouse Cafe is located, just a couple of miles down the road. Now, you can also cut off this road over the tops up to Tarnhowers and drop down into Coniston over the mountain to my right hand side. So just looking at these dry stone walls in between the hedges, absolutely everywhere in the Lake District. Must have taken some man hours to build those. There's not many people left, I don't think, in the lakes that can actually build those walls properly. It's definitely a skill set that's perhaps not being passed down generations at the moment. Now, there's a right turn just here where this Pathfinder's going. That'll take you to Tarnhowers up that way. One way to get over to it, and then over towards Coniston. And then just as we get to the tree line just up here, is where the Boathouse Cafe is. You can literally drive past it, because it's it does come up on you quite quickly as you get round this corner. This is where they hire the fishing boats out for all of the anglers. Okay, so the carrot cake and cappuccino went down well. As you can see, it's absolutely stunning down here. Now, if you're coming in the morning, you'll have the sun facing you on the terrace where you can have your coffee and your lunch, whatever you're eating, which is nice. But in the afternoon, the sun goes behind the hill, so the cafe is in the shade in the afternoon. Just a tip. It's been a beautiful day, and we're going to head back down to Lancashire just now. So, as I wander back to the bike, thanks again for tuning in, and if you're not a subscriber to the channel, don't forget to subscribe, hit that like button, and I'll see you on the next video, which will be next weekend. We're out on Sunday this Easter with a couple of mates, so we'll get some filming done on that trip and bring that to you next weekend. So have a good one, and catch you soon. Ciao for now.